plastic mood sugar.
This one gives thanks. Do not disturb the ritual, cub. Our harvest depends upon it.
All this wasted effort. First the hurricane, then rats from the sea. What next, flying mud crabs? Surrender's mercy, we need more time before the inspection. Dominion inspectors. Headwoman Harani requested their aid to stop smugglers. We're honest farmers with good customers. Our moon sugar is used to spice food, not to brew skooma. When the inspectors learn we can't protect our fields, we're finished. Hairy, squirmy, squeaky little rats. They've infested the plantation since the storm. The inspectors will ask, if we can't protect our fields from those dung-dropping sugar eaters, how can we protect them from skooma brewing thieves? Find out why Cindertail's cinch tigers roll on their backs instead of filling their bellies with rat. Does one expect to keep his job if the inspectors find vermin in our fields? At best, the inspectors will recommend our moon sugar be confiscated. To the east, a plantation burns. Was it due to the inspectors' recommendations? Who can say? Either way, Mistral will weep for our passing. With Laughing Moons gone, skooma will flow through the streets. When moon sugar runs dry, people turn to smugglers. With smugglers come skooma. But the inspectors aren't from here. If we tell them, they will not listen. find out why Cindertail's Senge Tigers roll on their backs instead of filling their bellies with rat. Does one...
Ferocious killers? Pah! Unclawed blankets, more like. Want to buy a carpet? How about three? They aren't good for much else. Yes, Afe, even you. Do not eat the rats, this one says. Do they listen? No! Stupid Sench. Lazy Sench. Already did. That's the problem. Moon sugar makes you sleepy if you eat too much. Rats eat moon sugar, Sench eat rats, and then lazy Sench. Especially you, Gobani. Not with sugar bellies. These useless Sench could only kill a rat if they fell upon it. From a great height. Go inside, lock the doors, wait until they leave? No. Let this one think. Without Sench hunters, what could... Thunderbugs. No, it would never work. Thunderbugs nest nearby. They defend their delicious eggs from anyone who'd make a meal of them, yes? If you grabbed an armload of eggs... Undoubtedly, but they'd hesitate to harm the eggs once you possess them. Smash an egg into each rat nest, and the Thunderbug's electric frenzy kills the rats before the inspectors arrive. You're sturdy, yes? A little shock won't stop you. Wonderful! Save some eggs for Cindertail, yes? They are so very tasty.
Thank you.
did not expect you so soon, Inspector Tarmar.
Yeah! One must arrive early.
Hello.
Clever luring Thunderbugs out of their mounds like that. A scheme worthy of Bandar himself. They're all gone, then? Excellent. Our gracious inspector has been most patient with us. Perhaps witnessing your ingenuity will affect his findings. Joan and Joe dance kindly with you, Walker. Whatever the findings of our esteemed inspector, we are in your debt. Will you be staying with us long, Inspector?
It's taking forever.
As long as necessary. One can only tolerate so much fresh air.
Truly. Then we'll endeavor to make your stay comfortable.
Don't fret over much. If my duty requires it, I can tolerate such rustic accommodations.
Another distraction.
Can any of you hear me?
You there. Have you seen my squad?
We were all in the little Alkosh, part of the Dominion fleet sailing for Kanathi's roost. Then a hurricane blew up out of nowhere. Sails tore, hulls cracked, and we were thrown into the ocean. I ended up here, but I can't find the rest of my squad. I thought I heard one of them calling out. But the ocean twists up sounds. If they're wounded or pinned down, could you keep an eye out for my soldiers? They answer to Edelus, Onglon, and Nistel. Two of us can cover more ground. I'm sure my squad made it to shore alive. Dominion Marines constantly defy the sea's attempts to drown us. But hurricanes are another matter. I fear my squad is banged up worse than I am. Our ship's hold was packed full of an old Bosmer healing remedy. The labels say torchbug treacle, but Marines call it glow juice. The wreck's scattered bottles across the beach must be what brought out the ailids.
Squat creatures made of teeth, claws, and endless hunger. I've heard their cries up and down the beach since I came to. Their sweet tooth is bigger than their walnut brains. I saw one of the stupid things swallow a whole bottle of glow juice.
Good luck. Do me a favor. If you find them before I do, tell them the ocean hasn't killed me yet.
enemy falls. Rise up from below. Waning crescent.
Sifra, I'm glad you came by. Have you seen any other Marines along the beach? She's alive. I suppose that's some luck amidst all this wreckage. Can't say the same for my leg. If I don't put too much weight on it, I can manage a good hobble.
tide. We've got to.
Land. Have we reached land? But the room still spins. Why did I board this accursed ship? The Prowler needed a cook, so I volunteered. First time to travel by sea. Thought all the water would be like the marshes back home. But now even the smell of food. Oh, gods. Oh.
Oh, has the storm stopped? I don't think I've ever been this sick.
I lost a lot of friends in that storm. Give me some good news. I saw her swept overboard in that damn storm. Held on to the rigging long as I could, but it tore the skin off my palms. If I can't hold a weapon, I'm useless to my squad. Do you have any bandages? I lost my kit to the... Blow juice? Used to think this stuff was only good for practical jokes on snowy days. Once I can heft Spleen Shanker, I'll push through the beach and find Sergeant Ferian. How about you? Hope they appreciate their good fortune when you find them. I can get inland after I rest. Fight with purpose.
Yeah. are you? Were you part of the fleet? Alive? Good. That's good. Wave smashed me against the ship. Cracked a few ribs. Not the best feeling. Tastes like sandals boiled in mint perfume. But if it knits my ribs, I'll drink the whole bottle. Good. I'll find Sergeant Firion. Go. Get them back safe.
Praise the gods, you're back! I thought you were an ailet. Glotus. By the gods, it just might. Soon as I can stand on my own, I'll head inland. Lieutenant Gellin dragged me out of the water. He'll want to know Sergeant Firion and the rest of the squad are all right. I think he said something about looking for shelter in a nearby cave. I was still coughing up sand.
Turns out my squad were the ones who found me. Ever consider a career as a Dominion Marine? You'd make quite a scout. My squad said you were looking for Lieutenant Gellin. Have you found him?
What do you mean?
First, a hurricane blows out of nowhere and destroys our fleet. Then, an able-bodied Dominion Marine is captured and tortured to death? What else was in that cave? Some kind of sacrifice? This is too big for my squad to handle. We need reinforcements. Nistel spotted a beach ship nearby. It looks intact, and she spotted Dominion sailors aboard. We need to combine our forces and find who murdered Lieutenant Gellin. My squad and I need to pull his body out of that damn cave. Would you warn the sailors on that beach ship? They need to know it's not safe to wander around. Turns out my squad were the ones who found me.
What do you mean?
First, a hurricane blows up some kind of sacrifice. We need to combine our forces and... Wait. Take this. I found some glow juice while I was looking for my squad. But they're on the mend. You'll get used to the taste. We'll be along shortly. Watch yourself.
The Prowler will float, but I can't promise more than that.
A slick-arsed sea viper or a cabbage-mouth castaway. State your business with the crew of the Prowler. The hurricane killed hundreds of Marines. Why does it matter if one of them died in a cave? Oh. Well, the Prowler is like a hen in a wolf den until she's seaworthy again. Maybe your Marines can prove they're more than two-legged cargo and shiny armor. If they pitch in, I'll consider reinforcements. They up for it? Or are they all talk? And I'm sure they'll be as useful as they were in the hurricane. Should they care to prove otherwise, they're welcome to do actual work patching leaks in the Prowler's hold. Maybe they can locate a replacement helmsman's wheel in all this wreckage. Oh, and our Sunsighter. It must have fallen overboard when we beached. Our lookout saw those skink-fingered pirates make off with it. You'll have to get the Sunsighter back, any way you can. Sure, talking's easier than working. Well, ask. Barnacles on the arse. They're all sea elves. Malmer, they call themselves. Nothing more than pirates, if you ask me. Some say they have a connection to the water itself, but it's a lie. Anyone can learn weather magic like they do. Captain Jimala uses it to navigate. I could tell you how the sun and stars show the ship's exact position, but none of it matters while it's in the Sea Viper's hands. The pride of the Long Coast. We'll sail for the Dominion as long as they pay us to raid enemy shipping. Joan and Joad, don't let the captain hear you say that. Pirates steal and pillage for themselves. We're privateers, so we do it for whoever pays us. A crucial distinction.
These aren't Dominion sailors. They're privateers. Just our luck. We'll show that old sea cat what Dominion Marines can do. Edelus is the best scrounger in the regiment. If you want, I can send him out to look for a helmsman's wheel. He's on his way. Anything else we can do? Nustellus is good with a mallet as she is with her sword. I can have her patch the Prowler's leaks. She'll have those leaks fixed in no time. What else? Onglorn is our best tracker. He can recover the Sun Cider in no time. I almost pity the Sea Viper who's holding on to the Sun Cider. Onglorn will recover it soon enough. What else needs doing? But it's time for that mangy privateer to make good on his promise. Maybe you should do the talking. I'll just rub it in.
That was fast. All right. There's room on the Prowler for your Marine friends, as long as they work for their meals. I said I'd consider it. Captain Jimmela is the only one who can make that call. Something you'll want to hear. You just made the Prowler seaworthy, and Captain Jimmela always pays her debts. Go talk to her. She only bites if you give her good reason.
Your efforts, the Prowler is free to sail once the tide comes in. Those Marines did their part as well. I have no reinforcements, but I offer something better. I know who's killing the Dominion soldiers, and I know how to stop it. Our lookout watched the Sea Vipers drag a Dominion Marine into a cave. Later, he saw your friends remove the Marine's body. If we weren't so short-handed, I'd have ordered his rescue. But three of my own crew were missing. Before we understood the danger, I sent my crew to scavenge among the shoals so we might repair the Prowler. We thought they disappeared, but one just returned, and she tells a harrowing tale. The Sea Vipers happened. Now there's a new storm brewing, and I fear they're the cause of it. Mustengui recovers below. Hear what she has to say for yourself.
The Sea Vipers are insane! They're trying to create another hurricane! Sir Verkvild and I were scavenging for a replacement helmsman's wheel when the Sea Vipers ambushed us. They brought us to the island with the beached Dominion flagship. They'd done things there. Terrible things. Those filthy Maurmer dragged my mates up and tied them to these serpent-shaped statues. Then they started chanting, and lightning surrounded them. That's when the storm began to form around the island. Yes, I'm sure of it. It was a terrible sight. The sea vipers were so caught up in the ritual, I slipped free. I tried to grab Sir, but the lightning held him fast. Then one of the sea vipers yanked at him. I saw the Maurimer's wrist glow. The Maurimer wore lodestones on their wrists. It let them ignore those lightning bonds, but I couldn't find any more, so I jumped off the ship and swam for it. Please, don't let them sacrifice my crewmates.
Thank you.
Sur and Verkvild returned just after the skies cleared up. They're a bit damp, but otherwise all right. My lookout says I have you to thank. Then we'll finish repairs and shove off at high tide. Oh.
I'll be done soon.
We've got some flooding in the hold, Captain.
Still watching us? Of course they are.
Thank you.
We just put out for Haven when this storm hit. Our ship foundered on some rocks, and we had to swim back to land. Now we wait for another vessel to hire us on.
You're here. Go. Keep your wits about you, my new friend. Mistral's houses cast deep shadows, and vipers lurk in the tall grass. Mistral is the jewel of the Southern Seas, a free port with trade ties to half of Tamriel. Ambassadors from the Dominion arrived weeks ago to negotiate its admission into the Alliance. Unfortunately, things have not gone smoothly. Kenarthi's Roost has an old treaty with the Maumer. They claim the Dominion fleet intended to invade their home waters. It's a sticking point in the negotiations. The Sylvanar could use some help. Fine. Without Mistral's support, the Dominion will have precious little defense on its southern coasts. But we are not here to conquer anyone. The Sylvanar knows this. He is in the Chancery, seeking a peaceful resolution here. The High Elves, Wood Elves, and Khajiit stand united under the Eagle Banner. We secure our borders against invaders from the Covenant and Pact, but it is no easy task. And Queen Irene leads our Dominion, of course. He is the voice and spirit of the Wood Elves. They say he is, was, and will be their greatest leader, whatever that means. This one knows him as an unrivaled diplomat. He is also the Dominion's best hope of resolving this matter peacefully. Razumdar is just a simple Khajiit. He seeks the best for all the people of Tamriel. Also, a saddle that won't pinch the tail. One day.
Not too keen on that. A little town like this won't be able to pay up front. We're leaving on the next boat we can get, right?
You have a better idea? Spit it out!
Hey, ideas aren't my strong suit. I'm just saying, look at this place. Do they look like they can afford us?
You have a point. Matbia, what else?
Let's ask around. I'm sure
my temper is short, and my blade is long.
I see the delight in your eyes.
The Sylvanar blind. Every one of these sea elves is a venomous serpent, waiting. Lorcan, take them all. Why did the Sylvanar negotiate with these filthy Maumer?
There's nothing more dull than a petty criminal.
Those pirates are a stick in the High Elf eye. They capture our merchant ships and raid our settlements. If I had any say, we'd negotiate with a sword at their throats. Not as long as the Sylvanar confuses diplomacy with capitulation. He's inside with the rest of them, pretending this won't end in bloodshed. Go. See this farce for yourself.
Your pardon, friend. The Dominion's arrival on Carnathy's roost has upset the locals. It falls on me to smooth the waters. Please, help yourself to food or drink. I'm happy to speak with you once this matter is settled. Most unexpected. It seems we have a mutual friend. May I ask, what brings you to Mistral? Then perhaps you can advise me on a small matter. The Maoma have a treaty with Carnathy's roost. This is nothing to fear. A treaty is something I can work with. Yet neither Ambassador Ulondil nor Headwoman Harani will produce a copy. Indeed, why not? It would be indecorous to suggest the treaty is anything but actual and sound, yet I fear it won't present itself without a more active line of inquiry. Would you be my voice in this with Ambassador Ulondil and Headwoman Harani? Exactly. A chorus of requests may succeed in carrying the tune. Harani in particular seems eager to see this resolved, though I fear the Dominion presence binds her hands. But I'll leave you to it.
It's hard to keep track of the new faces since the hurricane, but I don't believe we've met. Welcome to Mistral. May your stay here be full of warm winds and soft sand. And I told him. The mere act of doing so would complicate matters with our longtime Maomer allies. They take great offense to the Dominion's claims upon our island. Look around you. What great armies do you see? Our survival depends on knowing when to fight and when to please. The treaty brought us prosperity for generations. I will not be the one to break it.
We upheld our treaty with the people of Carnathy's Roost for generations. And this is how they repay our kindness? We will not allow High Elf thieves to gain a foothold in our territorial waters. By all rights, this is our island. Harani's people occupy it with our blessing. If she breaks the treaty, so breaks our truce. We'll take back our island, and the Khajiit will pay the price. We keep a copy on an island far from here. I see no reason to send for it. I won't allow High Elf Warfrats another chance to take our rightful lands. Why don't you bother Harani for her copy?
This one thinks you have come to make a deposit, yes? This one thinks you have come to make a deposit, yes?
Any luck securing a copy of the treaty? Then there's little chance for compromise. I'll call a break in formal talks until everyone calms their nerves. You understand the stakes, yes? It's why I ask you to take a more active role in locating the treaty. I don't do so lightly. I can't allow the Dominion's first act on Carnathy's Roost to be one of conquest. I understand our mutual friend prefers the rum served at a nearby tavern. Perhaps he would have ideas on securing a copy of the treaty. freshly grown fruit, still without blemish. On behalf of the Bosm people, it's my goal to keep it that way. If you speak with the Green Lady, don't mistake her manner as distaste for the Dominion. She simply misses our home of Valenwood. She sustains me, and I her. Together, we are the aspirations of the Bosma people given form. Put simply, she is the love of my life. Also, she grows ill-humored when I gush about her within earshot. I'd best say no more. It's a name, a title, and our holy city. Quite an honor to carry around such an important word and the occasional burden in its confusion of outsiders. Not even the Green Lady calls me by my given name. Edelorn doesn't roll off the tongue, I suppose. As Sylvanar, seems like it's been such a short while, but the wrinkles on my face tell me differently. Or did you mean as Dominion?
Bring this one another goblet.
You think this one drinks on the job? Good. Then so will everyone else. What is the word, my new friend? Ulandil certainly won't. His viper tongue is sharp. But Harani can't because her copy was stolen. It only takes 3 drinks to loosen the tongue of the Chancery clerk, if you were curious. A good question. Raz answers it with an interesting bit of trivia. Ulandil posted a guard at his quarters the day of the theft. His subtlety is rivaled only by his pleasant personality. Oh, and it's 5 drinks for embassy staff. 6 puts them out. Someone needs to slip into Marmor Embassy. Find a way past the guard and rifle through Ulandil's private quarters. Oh, and do it without bloodshed that could provoke war with the Maumer. In case he was not clear, Raz is talking about you. The pragmatist in this one says it's because you have no firm connection to the Dominion. The optimist says it's because you have proven yourself more than capable already. When you have the treaty, meet both of us at the bridge.
Be disgusted by its cold, oozing nose. In Daggerfall, packs of these horrible monsters roam the streets at night and prey upon the unwary. My own father, divine save his soul, was torn to pieces by just such
joining the Dominion isn't about what is taken from it, but what we gain from each other. Watch your step, groundwalker.
Don't cause trouble.
Another one?
Ambassador Ulondil isn't here. And if he was, he'd be far too busy to entertain the likes of you.